Ertugliflozin is a SGLT2 inhibitor used to treat type 2 diabetes mellitus. In this video, let's find found. What is ertugliflozin? What is ertugliflozin used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking ertugliflozin? How does ertugliflozin work? How to use ertugliflozin? What is ertugliflozin? Ertugliflozin, sold under the brand name Steglatro, is a medication for the treatment of type 2 diabetes. The most common side effects include fungal infections of the vagina and other infections of the female reproductive system. In the United States, it was approved by the Food and Drug Administration for use as a monotherapy and as a fixed-dose combination with either sitagliptin or with metformin. In the European Union, it was approved in March 2018 for use as a monotherapy or combination therapy. A combination with metformin is marketed as Segluromet and a combination with sitagliptin is marketed as Steglujan. What is ertugliflozin used for? Ertugliflozin is indicated as an adjunct to diet and exercise to improve glycemic control in adult patients with type 2 diabetes mellitus. It is also available in combination with either metformin or sitagliptin for the same indication. Contraindication. Under the U.S. approval, ertugliflozin is contraindicated for patients with severe kidney failure, end-stage renal disease, and dialysis. The European Union approval does not list any contraindications apart from hypersensitivity to the drug, which is standard for all drug approvals. Side effects. Adverse effects in studies that were significantly more common under ertugliflozin than under placebo included mycosis of the genitals in both men and women, vaginal itch, increased urination, thirst, hypoglycemia, low blood sugar, and weight loss under the higher dosing scheme. A rare but life-threatening side effect of gliflozins is ketoacidosis. It occurred in 3 patients, 0.1%, in ertugliflozin studies. To lessen the risk of developing ketoacidosis, a serious condition in which the body produces high levels of blood acids called ketones, after surgery, the FDA has approved changes to the prescribing information for SGLT2 inhibitor diabetes medicines to recommend they be stopped temporarily before scheduled surgery. Ertugliflozin should be stopped at least 4 days before scheduled surgery. Pharmacodynamic. Administration of ertugliflozin increases urinary glucose excretion, which leads to a negative balance and osmotic diuresis. Thus, this antidiabetic agent has been reported to significantly reduce the body weight and blood pressure of diabetic patients. Mechanism of action. As part of a normal process, the glucose from the blood is filtered for excretion and reabsorbed in the glomerulus, so less than 1% of this glucose is excreted in the urine. The reabsorption is mediated by the sodium-dependent glucose cotransporter, SGLT, mainly the type 2, which is responsible for 90% of the reabsorbed glucose. Ertugliflozin is a small inhibitor of the SGLT2 and its activity increases glucose excretion, reducing hyperglycemia without the requirement of excessive insulin secretion. Half-life. The terminal elimination half-life of ertugliflozin is 11 to 17 hours. Dose. Type 2 diabetes mellitus. Indicated as an adjunct to diet and exercise to improve glycemic control in adults with type 2 diabetes mellitus. Recommended starting dose is 5 mg PO/Qday in the morning. If starting dose tolerated and additional glycemic control is needed, increase dose to maximum of 15 mg Qday. Safety advice. AUTGA pregnancy category D, drugs which have caused, are suspected to have caused or may be expected to cause, an increased incidence of human fetal malformations or irreversible damage. These drugs may also have adverse pharmacological effects. Accompanying texts should be consulted for further details. That's all the information about ertugliflozin we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video, to update more health information.